Good day to you from ChemHelp ASAP. Let's work through another sample Diels-Alder problem from start to finish. Here are our diene and dienophile. Our first step is to make sure the diene can assume an s-cis conformation. It's locked as s-cis, so this is not an issue. The second step is to consider regiochemistry. The diene is symmetrical except for this hydroxymethyl group. The hydroxymethyl is an alkyl group, an EDG, and will drive the regiochemistry. As an EDG, let's give the CH2 a minus. Now alternate charges as we move away from the CH2 and into the diene carbons. Plus, minus, plus, minus. Notice that all the diene atom charges alternate. Let's now look at the dienophile. Whoops, the dienophile is completely symmetrical. We have the same groups on the ends of the dienophile carbons. If either the diene or dienophile is symmetrical, then you don't need to worry about regiochemistry. Lucky us. The third step is to draw the approach of the diene and dienophile. Let's redraw the diene with an edge on view. Forward will be those. There are our numbers. Okay, let's put the dienophile alkene underneath. Now let's place the ester groups onto the dienophile alkene. Well, the ester on C6 has a CO pi bond. It will want to go endo. Of course, since those two esters are trans in the dienophile, the other ester on C5 must go exo. Those groups must be trans. There's no way around this. One ester can be endo, but the other must be exo. Let's add our hydrogens. The fourth step is to draw the product. Here is our cyclohexene for our product. Number our ring atoms. Let's add the groups. The up groups first. On the C1, there is a CH2. I'm going to draw it to the inside. On C4 is another CH2, and they are connected. C5 has an ester that is up. C6 has a hydrogen. Now the down groups. The hydroxymethyl on 1 is technically down. C4 is H. C5 is H. C6 is the ester. Bicyclic structures look terrible flat, so let's give it some three-dimensionality. There we go. So this is on C6, the ester is down. And on C5, the ester is up. Here's a prettier picture, but it's still the same molecule. Note that we could have made the C6 ester go exo, bring it to the front. That would move the C5 ester to be endo. That would reverse both stereocenters. We just get the enantiomer of the product we've drawn. We do not typically worry about which enantiomer we draw, so either product is fine and equally likely to form. We'll get a racemic mixture of the two enantiomers. All right, that's another Diels-Alder example. First, make sure the diene is s-cis, then determine regiochemistry, draw how the diene and dienophile align, and then draw the product.